It's almost been a year since then. Actually, it's been more like friggin' 5 minutes. The FBI moved into action, arresting some of its own and some missed officers on charges of collaboration with a private organization. However, all information regarding the organization running the shelter has been classified. Nothing was ever explained and we were slapped with the gag order. Kinky. The report released to the public explained the events as an armed cultist uprising and its suppression. Just like that, the case was closed. Neo-mitochondria were filed and forgotten. But we weren't going to just sit around twiddling our thumbs. Following Baldwin's arrest, Rupert took the senior post. He's working with Jody on a secret project, the full public disclosure of MIST and the NMCs. The Japanese biologist Dr. Maeda has proposed a new superhuman theory. By identifying the neomitochondrial DNA, he calculated the frequency of latent carriers over a 10-year span. His theory that these carriers would lead the evolution of the human species is not widely accepted. It was enough to interest Pierce. He's been working with Dr. Maeda, looking for carriers all over the net. They really hit it off, and their projects are going well. Pierce thinks that my case, in which the neomitochondria merely strengthen their host instead of taking outright control, is the true path to mutual prosperity. They intend to educate possible carriers before they transform, and thereby reduce the occurrence of NMCs and other persecution of carriers that would follow. It's clear from this devotion, Pierce has found his life work. His character has changed too. No more timid Pierce. Jody is greatly relieved too. Rupert pulled some strings in the FBI.
I just screwed up lines right there. Let's try that again.
Rupert pulled some strings at the FBI and for me and Eve. She's now my younger sister. No questions asked. She's been going to junior high for a month now and loves it. Her face reveals nothing of her dark past. She is full of life and quite popular at school. It also seems that she's lost her neomitochondrial powers. Mr. Douglas was serious.
Gary lived.
Well, of course, Flint did too. And I love that. Everyone has their own specific signature by their names, except for Flint. He's got a paw print, which is actually kind of kick-ass. Anyways, Mr. Douglas was seriously injured in the explosion, but he's recovered and is now rebuilding Dryfield. He sent me a picture of a rifle scope, price tag attached. We've all dealt with what happened in our own way, starting new lives. Only Kyle hasn't been seen. Not since that day. I run searches for him now and then, but no luck. I haven't even found a trace. If he hadn't shot me, I wonder if he really existed at all. Well, I shot you right in the tit, so I'm pretty sure he's real. But he saved Eve and he saved me. Or was it all a dream? I hope he didn't get into trouble on account of his helping us. In the meantime, I'll keep searching. After all, he was the one who told me, never give up. Kind of reminds me of Zack from Final Fantasy VII. Once again, I'm making that reference again because he's got that sweater vest thing. Anyways, tomorrow I'm taking my first vacation in a long while. Too bad that I don't get vacations where I work at. Pierce got Eve and me passes to the Nature Museum. Eve craves knowledge. She's so excited about tomorrow she can't sleep. I'll have to brush up if I'm going to be able to answer some of her questions. Now this FMV cutscene that's about to occur, you only get with the good ending, so just for warning you now, viewers. If you got the bad ending, well, you're not getting this cutscene. Where's everyone else at the Nature Museum? What, do people not really crave knowledge besides these two? What's up with that hologram just kind of like floating right there? That's pretty kick-ass. Why is no one else at this museum? What happened? I saw Kyle.
Kyle Reese? No, it was Kyle Madigan. Okay, well now, viewers, that is the end of Let's Play Parasite Eve 2! So, I'll go on ahead and just give my review of the game as I always do whenever I do my Let's Plays during the credits. Now, this game, whenever it... Yes, it is based on the novel Parasite Eve by Kadokawa Horobunko, which is written by Hideki Sena. Anywhom, my review on this game is that whenever I first played it, in all honesty, I really underestimated the game, because it took on the new style that wasn't the old Parasite Eve style, and, well, I missed out on it back whenever, you know, I was younger. But all is made up because I made a Let's Play for it in the end, and oh my god, that face is ugly! Get it out of my... Just get it off the computer screen! Thank you. There we go, now we have Kyle pointing a gun. But anywho, my review on this game is that, well, as I've already said before, I underestimated it because it was not at all like, you know, the very first Parasite Eve. But in the end, the graphics are fantastic for the time. And actually, they still kind of hold up today, but like, other standards, I guess. But the storyline was actually pretty good. It kind of gets confusing a little bit, but overall, I would give the story about a 4 out of 5. The graphics, I would give 5 out of 5, because, well, Square Enix has really never disappointed with graphics ever. Or, for the most part, they never have. For the music, I thought the music was okay, but the first Parasite Eve soundtrack is where I personally think that's where it's at. So the soundtrack on this, I would give about a 3 out of 5. The only real soundtrack, or the only real music that I really like in this are actually the final battle and like maybe a couple of other songs here and there, but for the most part, the soundtrack I wouldn't give too high of a rating. As for the gameplay itself, it's kind of a Resident Evil style, but it takes on its own form and enhances that, you know, survival horror style, and it gives you some RPG elements, and it gives you some magics that you can use, which really helps you out. And also the targeting system was a little bit different. Speaking of the battle system, whenever you try targeting something, and if you target something else, like, you know, the past couple of videos, whenever I was trying to target that one golem and it only targeted the cameras, that was fairly annoying. So, the battle system was okay, but as for the targeting system, it really needed to be tweaked. Now, this music's kind of calming right now. Which might be a good thing, actually. But anywhom, so overall, I would give this game about a 4 out of 5. The first Parasite Eve, I still think, would hold up. It stands the test of time compared to Parasite Eve 2, in my opinion, but overall, Parasite Eve 2 is definitely worth checking out if you haven't already. Eh, yes, Yoko Shimomura, you created the... Oh! I lost my train of thought all of a sudden because I imagined the shower scene. Wait, Squarts? Squarts? What the hell is Squarts? Was that like the Schwartz from Spaceballs or something? Coca-Cola, the dynamic ribbon device, and other contour bottle designs are registered trademarks of the Coca-Cola Company. Once again, viewers, subliminal advertising in my Let's Play. Yes, I should be getting paid by Coca-Cola for releasing this video on YouTube. And there's Square, not Squarts, which is just really weird why it was called Squarts. I don't even know why it was. But this game is definitely worth checking out if you haven't already, and if you're interested in it, then I would suggest playing it. It's pretty good. Overall, I would give it about a 4 out of 5, and yep, we're not done yet, viewers. Out of all that, I get all that BP right there. And also, I get some more experience, but this is, you know, for the next replay bonus. Okay, I get the pike, I got the lipstick, and I got the tactical armor. Eh, screw it, we'll go on ahead and just save the game one last time, why not? Even though I don't plan on doing a new game plus as a Let's Play. But anyways, I'll go on ahead and just show you really quick what it's like. Change to disc one, son of a... Okay, I have to stand up and, like, walk all the way to the back of my room just to grab the disc case. Man, I'm wasting everyone's time again. Not that I haven't already done that enough during this Let's Play. Okay, here we go. Disc 2 is back in the case, and Disc 1 is going into the PlayStation 2. Yeah, I've actually been playing this on my PlayStation 2 the whole time. Because Parasite Eve 2 has not yet come out on the PlayStation Network, as far as my knowledge goes for it. But anyways, if you end up doing the new game right here... Wait. Why did I do new game? Why didn't I just do continue? Alright, well, I'm gonna go... Ah, let's go back to just continue. So, here we go. Whenever you can start New Game Plus right here. Okay, yes, I see the Mist Center, Los Angeles. See, you can do Bounty Mode or Replay Mode. So far, if you play Bounty Mode, it's actually kind of fun, but it halves your BP and experience that you gain from last playthrough, really. Or from the last playthrough. Hmm. Alright, well anyways, yeah, that's pretty much the replay modes that they have in this game, and thank you all for watching Let's Play Parasite Eve 2. This finale episode has been quite long, so I'll see you all in my next Let's Play, and hopefully you all still watch it. So, thank you all for watching, thank you all for subscribing, thank you all for supporting, I'll see you in the next Let's Play.